Well, hello everyone. Welcome to enjoythemuse.tv. This video features Bruce Ball of Questyle Audio. Let's go ahead and I'm gonna bring Bruce right in. Hey Bruce, how you doing?
Good, Steven, how are you, man?
Oh, good, so you're in San Francisco right now. Tell us about the show.
I am. We're at the San Francisco Headphone meet at the Wikia building in downtown San Francisco.
Cool.
And we're showing several of our new products, our reference gold stack and the new all-in-one CMA600i.
Yep.
And then, of course, we've got our usual standards, the 800R and 192D, as well as the QP1Rs.
Nice. Looks like you got a good little crowd going there.
Yeah, it's been really busy all day. This is actually the first lull that we've had, so the timing's pretty good. I can actually walk around the room a little bit. It's been really crowded. This has been a really well-attended show, and we've been pretty packed all day.
Yeah, well, this is actually, just so people know, the show actually just kind of closed. So we're taking advantage of that to have this quiet time with you.
Yeah, we've got one more hour left, so it closes at 6. So we're kind of just winding down now.
So
it's been pretty good, though.
Cool. So why don't you tell us a little about the gold reference components, because that's something you just released.
Yeah, we just started showing it. We actually introduced it at January CES, and we brought some prototypes, basically, and we're now in full production on it, and we've been showing it at the last couple of shows. We had it at Expona in Chicago, and we're showing it here as well. We're doing something kind of fun here at the San Francisco meet. We've got three premier headphones that we're running on our gold system. We've got the Focal Utopias, which are $4,000 retail, the Hi-Fi Man HE1000s, which I believe are $3,000 retail, and the LCD4s from Odyssey.
Nice.
So we're letting people compare those three headphones on our reference system. And it's been really interesting. You know, people have had, very different opinions on which ones they like better, and there really hasn't been a clear winner. We've had, pretty much just across the board, some people like one, some people like the other. So it's been a lot of fun.
Well, that's the whole point of, like, these meets, is that you get to try all this different equipment. There's no such thing as the best of, because there's a lot of personal preference.
Absolutely. We've had a lot of people bringing in their own headphones and bringing in their own DAPs and, cord mojos and all kinds of things. And we've been pretty open to people testing out different things with our product or with some of our headphones. So people have been bringing in their cell phones or their own DAP and want to hear one of the headphones we have on display with something that they own. And, we're pretty open to that. We want people to come in and have a good time and enjoy themselves.
Now, you guys have a really cool DAP yourself. The QPR1, which I've personally reviewed, and I love it. It is great.
Thank you. Yeah, it's been really exciting. We've been getting a lot of awards on it. We've had very, very positive reviews on it, and it's been a really good seller for us. So we're really excited about it.
Well, I'm going to give people a little beauty shot, as I call it, of it. The QPR1 is this cool little portable unit. Incredibly well done, and the sound quality, it's $899 as I recall.
Yep.
And the sound quality is just amazing. There's no doubt about it.
A lot of people don't know, we've also just come out with leather cases that are $59 retail. And they're all like, Italian glove leather. They're really, really nice. We do them in black, in tan, as well as a finisher we call Elephant Gray, which is kind of a textured, more of a suede type material.
Mm-hmm.
And then the tan one's got a really soft, really nice feel to it as well. So the black and the tan are more of a soft glove leather, and the gray one, what we call Elephant Gray, is more of a textured suede type finish.
Ah. So there we go. And what else are you showing in San Francisco this weekend?
We've got, like I said, we've got our gold reference systems. We also have the new CMA600i, which is kind of become the rock star of our line right now. We've been getting a lot of excitement on these. It's $1,299 retail, uses the AKM DAC chip in it. And it's got a four-pin balanced out for people that want to use balanced headphones. And it's also got two quarter-inch parallel jacks, so two people can listen to it at the same time. And it's remote controllable. It's got a motorized Alps attenuator in it. So it's a lot of bang for the buck for $1,299. It's probably my favorite product in the line right now. I'm really excited about it. It's the first desktop model that we've done in space gray, which is something I've been begging the factory for, is to make me a desktop piece in space gray, because I just think it's really unique. There's a lot of black and a lot of silver gear out there, but space gray is kind of not a real common thing to find in desktop components. And I've got one over here that we actually have a clear top on.
That'd be great. Yep. So this way people can see the build quality, because that's one thing I have to admit is you guys, Questyle, pays so much attention to not just the sound quality, but the build quality, the reliability, the parts you use.
Absolutely. That's really what we're all about. We try to build the highest quality product we possibly can. As you know, that we're building all of our stuff at Foxconn, so we've got quite a bit of resources behind us and, unlimited CNC machines and everything, so we're able to do a lot of things that most high-end companies aren't really capable of doing, such as in our gold reference systems, we're using ceramic circuit boards from Rogers, which I believe we're the only company in the audio industry that is using those. And the noise floor on them is just really, really low. It's the distortion rating is, I think, 0.22%. So it's just, it's clean. As Steve Hansen said at Expona, he said it was like you're not even wearing headphones. You're just simply there. And I think that was really the best way to describe it, because it just gives you a soundstage and sound quality in very black space that... You forget you're wearing headphones. You really do feel like you're actually in the live, in the studio listening to a live performance.
Right. Well, this is something I'm glad you brought up, because you are using the same people as like Apple and a lot of the big contenders use. And Foxconn is incredibly talented at building small, high quality units, such as the QPR1. I have no qualms in having them build anything I would spec, that's for sure.
Yeah, they build all of the Apple products, which is pretty much common knowledge. They build a lot of other products that I can't say, what brands are being built there, but they build a lot of consumer electronics. I was amazed walking through there and seeing all of the different brands of hi-fi equipment, cell phones. Actually, I shouldn't say hi-fi equipment, but, things like Xboxes, PlayStations, a lot of the gaming consoles and such. They do bell housings for a lot of the German car manufacturers, the big transmission bell housing. Mm-hmm. And watching one of those things being cut in a CNC machine is just absolutely fascinating. It's really incredible what they're able to do there, and it's the biggest factory you could possibly imagine.
Miles.
It really is. Their factory, what they call it, is Foxconn City, and it literally is
its own city.
They've got their own police department. They've got their own hospital. They have literal borders within Shenzhen that you have to go through their border checkpoint to get into Foxconn City. So it's pretty amazing.
Now, let's see. I don't believe we mentioned the 800R stack.
No, we haven't. We're
keeping you on your toes.
We're doing the stereo 800R as opposed to the monoblock, since we have the gold stack running in dual
in
mono.
Yep.
So this system as it is $4,000 retail. It's a stereo headphone amp with our true DSD DAC. And We're running that with a variety of different headphones from Enigma Acoustics, Odyssey, Mr. Speakers, Ether C, and Ether. We've kind of been moving headphones around from system to system because I've got more systems than I do headphones in here right now. So.
It looks like you must have six systems?
Yeah, we've got, I think we've got four of the 600i's running, four or five, two of the gold reference systems, and the CMA800R with the 192D, and then, of course, the QP1Rs. We've got seven of those going with Meza headphones, the signs from Odyssey, a pretty good selection of headphones that people can listen to it on something like the Meza, which are $300 retail, real easy to drive. You can drive them with a cell phone.
Yeah.
All the way up to, you know, something like an LCD3 or a Focal headphone, which is a much harder headphone to drive. And we're able to show people how much power the QP1R has, that it'll drive a variety of different headphones.
And that's one thing that definitely makes yours more unique than, I won't mention other brands, is there's a lot of power for headphone output.
There's a lot of power, and the reason for that is we actually have a pure Class A fully discrete amplifier built into it, and I believe it's the only one in the world that has a real Class A amp in it. So it's got quite a bit of power. It'll I haven't come across a headphone yet that it won't drive. We've been putting the Hi-Fi Man HE1000s on it, the Mr. Speakers, the Focals. Really pretty much anything we put on it, it seems to drive pretty well.
Awesome. So what else would you like to cover today?
Well, as I said, we've, at the end here, we've got the QP1Rs. I'm through my distribution company, Headsonics. I'm distributing the Meza headphones out of Romania.
Mm-hmm.
And they're a lot of bang for the buck. They're a really good headphone, and they're all made of solid wood. We've got a walnut version as well as a maple version with
beautiful. In white. Give us a close-up of the headphones, because they're so beautiful.
And inside the box, they include a hard shell case. And inside there's another small round pouch that's got two cables. One has a microphone on it that will work with Android, Apple, or Windows Phone.
Mm-hmm.
And, there's one on here. And then they include a much longer cable, and then all of the different connectors and adapters that you would need to use them on an airplane, on a desktop system. So it gives you a really nice package for $300 retail. It's quite a value.
Excellent.
And they sound phenomenal. And like I said, you can drive them with an iPhone or an Android phone. They're pretty
very
easy
sensitive.
To drive.
Yep.
And like, then, of course, you stick them on something like a QP1R, and it really lights them up.
Sweet. So any other things, last words?
That's about it that we're doing here. And we didn't bring our wireless system or anything, because we decided for the Headfi meet that we would just concentrate on our personal audio products. I think the next show that we're going to have our new wireless amps is going to be the Rocky Mountain show in Colorado.
Look forward to everyone there. And
yeah, that'll be a lot of fun.
Right, and that's in October in Denver. Huge show. Marjorie runs it, and I'm sure we'll see you there.
Absolutely. And I don't know if we were able to get a good close-up inside the gold reference system. One of the things that makes it really unique is the ceramic circuit boards, and they're very identifiable because they're white. So it's very easy to tell that it's a ceramic circuit board as opposed to the standard green or mm-hmm. black circuit boards. And the difference that just, changing the PCB made just was absolutely mind-boggling. I couldn't believe how much difference it made. Listening to the gold reference version versus the standard versions, and the only difference being the ceramic circuit boards and the grade of some of the resistors and some of the parts inside. So it was a pretty big leap for in performance without being too much more expensive.
And that's always a good thing, is trying to keep price downs, which is another thing with Questyle. You guys don't make these $25,000 and $50,000 units, do you?
Nope, absolutely not. We try to give the best value that we can, and we try to keep our prices down. With the QP1R, for instance, our three criteria when we designed it was, we wanted to come out with the best sounding player that we could possibly do, and the best sounding on the market if possible. Secondly was we wanted to keep it very simple to use and to operate and not have a lot of things like Android and stuff running on it to use up resources. And the third thing was we wanted to keep it under $1,000 so it was affordable and anybody could buy one. It wasn't, you know, something that's going to break the bank. So
well, I would definitely say success, because you hit all the marks.
Thank you. We hope so. That was our goal. So. But it's been a lot of fun. It's a really nice player, and they've been very reliable, and we've had a lot of success with them, and we've been selling them as fast as Foxconn can make them. So it's been a very successful product for us.
Nice. Well, we definitely appreciate you taking the time to spend with us here on Enjoy the Music TV.
I thank you for the opportunity. I appreciate it greatly.
As always, it's our pleasure. And that leads me to the outro. So let me say goodbye to Bruce. And
see you later. We'll see you down the road at the next show.
I think the next one
we've got is Rocky Mountain.
We'll see you there.
Alrighty, Steve. Thanks.
You take care, my friend.
You too.
Bye-bye. And that was Bruce of Questyle. Let me bring it back to me. I've reviewed their QPR1. They make great products, and they also keep it reasonably priced, but incredibly high quality. And that's one thing I love about their products. They're down to earth, but they keep a focus on quality and innovation, built at Foxconn, so you know the factory that's being made ensures the best of quality, because they make all the Apple products and on and on and on. Who am I? I guess for once I should run my lower thirds. I am somebody or other, but generally I'm called Stephen Rochlin of enjoythemusic.com and enjoythemusic.tv. And in the end, what really matters is that you enjoy the music. Hit it.